Welcome to AEROSPACE.
Hi guys, welcome to my channel AEROSPACE. You know, I'm Aishwarya, Assistant Professor of Aeronautical Engineering Department. And today I'm gonna do a video on a requested video. One of you have asked a question, how to solve a problem. So here comes the question. Now I will straight away go for the solution. Let me first read the question. For a flight level at cruise altitude, CD value, that is a coefficient of drag, is 0.018 with a drag coefficient at zero lift, CD naught equals to 0.015. For a 30 degree climb at the same altitude and speed, what will be the CD, that value into 10 power minus 3. Now let's see the given data. What are the given data? Given data at cruise condition. What is mean by cruise condition? When the aircraft is flying and when the lift is equivalent to weight and the drag is equivalent to thrust. So at that condition, the total CD, that is CD value, is 0.018, and CD naught, or we can other word we can say a parasite drag, is 0.015. Now the same thing they have asked for 30 degree climb when the same aircraft is flying. Now it's a horizontal, you can see here. Now same aircraft is inclining in 30 degree, so keeping the altitude, altitude, that means density is same, velocity, speed means velocity are same, and likewise since the same aircraft, so to the gross weight aspect ratio, or S, that is span area, will be considered to be same. Now see the solution. So these are the cruise condition I have written. So recall a drag polar equation. What is a drag polar equation? CD naught, CD equals to CD naught plus K CL square. Now we know at cruise condition this two value. We know this two value. Let's apply this two value. So when we apply this two value, so we can find the value of K CL square at cruise condition. At cruise condition, we can find the value of K CL square. So when you substitute here, you get 0.03. Let's name this as equation 1. Now what is the next condition? Now when the same aircraft is climbing 30 degree angle with the same rho, V, S and W. What is rho? Density, velocity, span area and the weight of an aircraft. Now this is an, what is this four symbol? This four symbol represents when an aircraft is leaving a cruise flight. So upward is a lift, downwards, directly downward is a weight, the forward or a flight path is called as thrust, and the opposite of that is called as a drag. So these are the four symbol represents. And the same thing when the aircraft, the second condition, when the aircraft is climbing 30 degree, This is what happens. The aircraft is traveling to 30 degree. So this was a horizontal and now this became the flight path. Now this becomes a thrust. From here, it becomes thrust here, drag here, lift here, but the weight remains same. That is acting downwards, vertically downwards. Now let's see, resolve the forces acting on a plane. So how we can resolve? Either in vertical forces and horizontal forces. So whatever the incline force here, incline, now we will take a reference as a flight path. Remember, don't do a mistake on it. If you're taking a horizon, you will get a different answer, since your wherever the flight path is taking or heading towards, that will be your reference line or reference path. Through that only you have to take or resolve the forces acting on an airplane. So First, I have taken the summation of vertical forces. So, what are the vertical forces? I can see there is a vertical forces left and the weight. So, upward force means we know is a positive and downward force means negative. So, I have resolved this force L minus W cos 30 and it will has to be equivalent to 0. Now I will take a summation of horizontal forces. Now what are the horizontal forces? And similarly, like when it is going on the right hand side, we take as positive. When going the left towards the left hand side, we take as a negative. Positive, negative. So T comes positive, then drag comes negative D minus this weight can be resolved in two parts. One is a cos term, one is another is a sin term. So here when we are taking on horizontal, minus W sin 30 will come. Now you got the resolved force acting on the airplane. Now we are going to solve each. Now I will take the horizontal one. Now consider the horizontal one. At steady level flight, we get as T equals to D, that is thrust equals to drag. And when you apply here, both the terms get cancelled off and you get W equals to whatever the terms is equals to 0. So the weight cannot be 0. So we can ignore this horizontal forces and we can go to the vertical force. Now see, when you go to vertical force, that is lift minus W cos 30 equals 0. Now L equals to W cos 30. Now what is meant by lift formula? Split the formula, half rho V square S CL equals to W cos 30. Now expand little more, keep the CL this side and other terms in another side. And cos 30 means 0.866. So name that an equation. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to square the CL square. Both the side. I'm going to square both the side. So when you square both the sides, CL square equals to this and this. Now why I'm doing this is, now after that we need to find the KCL square value. We need to find the KCL square value because again we need to apply the drag polar equation and there we need this. So what I did is, we found the CL square equals to this for when the aircraft is inclining 30 degree. Now I'm gonna multiply the k term on both the sides. So we multiplying k on this equation k, and when you square this term and round root of two digital numbers or digital value, we get as 0.75. Squaring of this term, we get as 0.75. Now recall the equation 1. In equation 1, what we have in steady time or cruise flight, KCL square, the value is 0.003. Now what you are going to do is, what is the value of that? Value is this, K2W rho V square S square. Right? Now, what you are going to do? Substitute the equation 1 in equation 2. Instead of this value, we are going to apply that. So when KCL square, this is for 30 degree climb. So when you write 0.003 into 0.75, you get as 0.00225. You get that. Now recalling the drag polar equation again. CD equals to CD naught plus KCL square. What is our requirement? Requirement is to find the CD equals to what are the value into 10 power minus 3 value. Now we know the CD naught value, it's constant because parasite drag, what is my parasite drag? So what is mean by parasite drag? It depends on the aircraft body and pressure that will remain constant for an aircraft. So CD naught value will be same what has been given here, that is 0.015, and KCL square for, this is for, we are finding for 30 degree climb. So this value we have to apply here. See here, see, now apply here, we get at 0.01725, right? So that means when you take as, we need to find what is this term into 10 power minus 3. and when you get as 17.25 into 10 power 6 3, and here they have not mentioned any two decimal places or any places, so better I prefer you better go for any two decimal places at least. And the answer ranges from 17.2 to 17.3. that means in between you can, this comes in between it. So that's the answer. I hope this session was useful for you guys, and I hope if you're practicing the gate question papers, and this will be quite useful for you. If you have further inquiry, you can drop down to my mail for your doubts and I will clarify your doubts. And don't forget to like, subscribe and comment. Have a nice day. Tata. Bye.